Welcome, fans of Fate Grand Order. I am Avon. This is FGO Tips. And today we're talking about stars. Not those stars. These stars. Critical stars. This is a follow-up to the beginner's guide on quick teams I posted recently as part of a collaboration with Caldia Gurus and Kawaii 5-0. Check out their channels if you're looking for the beginner's guide on Buster or Arts. In my intro to quick teams, we did a super short version of how to generate critical stars, but I had to cut out so much because it was a beginner's guide after all. But there's a lot of fun math involved in critical stars, and you know me, can't resist fun math. So without further ado, let's show that equation. Thanks to Kite over on Beast Slayer, we actually know a lot about how the game calculates critical star generation. Kite did some digging through the code itself and came up with this formula. Link to the original post in the description below. This is a little intimidating to look at right away, so let's break it down piece by piece. First of all, the servant star generate is based on the servant who is attacking, and directly reflects how well they are able to generate critical stars themselves. You can get a rough estimate of this value simply by knowing the class of your servant. This is where assassins stand out above the crowd with a base rate of 25%, way above the second place moon cancers and foreigners with a base rate of 15. Not far behind them are lancers at 12 and casters at 11. Others fall further and further down until you reach berserkers with the lowest rate of 5%. These numbers aren't exact though, because agility actually modifies the base rate for your servant. That's right, those letters you probably thought were just for fun actually do impact gameplay a little bit. The higher the agility, the higher the star gen rate for a servant. The changes are pretty small though, and will never be enough to make up for a bad class. Assassins like Serenity, Kotaro, and Summerskahak top the charts. Despite this, don't forget that the overall percentage is per hit. So hitting more times, like Jack who hits 5 times with each of her 3 quick cards, is still going to generate more stars, even though she has a slightly lower rate. Kotaro with 4 hits on each of his 3 quick cards is a very reasonable 3-star replacement though. The second part is first card bonus, and it's really easy. If the first card in the chain is a quick card, this number is 20%. Otherwise, it's 0. This is why starting your chain with a quick card will generate 20% more critical stars than normal. The next part is card star value. This is the star rate you see all the time on that chart that breaks down cards by types. If this is the second card in your chain and it's a quick card, the value will be 130%, or only 15% for a Buster card, and only 0% for an arts card. Noble Phantasms will always count as the first card no matter where they are in the chain, meaning 80% for quick, 10% for Buster, and still 0% for arts. The extra card at the end of a Brave chain counts at 100%. After that, we have card modifier, which means buffs or debuffs to your card effectiveness. Craft essences like Imaginary Around, servant skills like Crossing Arcadia, master skills like Reaction Reinforcement, and passive skills like Riding all apply here. They don't multiply each other, however, so their bonuses will be added together to generate the total card modifier value. Next up is server rate, which is a special value the game can use to tweak the amount of stars that different types of enemies generate. This is hard to calculate exactly, but thanks to people recording a lot of results, we've been able to estimate that some classes drop slightly more or less stars than others. In particular, it looks like riders drop the most, followed by archers. From a gameplay perspective, this kind of makes sense, since they are clearly encouraging us to use assassins to generate stars, and lancers are the second best generators out of all of the other base classes. Assassins and lancers themselves drop the least number of stars, for basically the same reason. After that, we have star drop modifier, which means buffs or debuffs to critical star generation rate. CEs like Be Elegant, servant skills like Navigation Advice, master skills like Stepping Stone to Ultimate Victory, and passive skills like Presence Concealment all apply here. All of these bonuses are added together to calculate the final star drop modifier. After that, we have enemy star drop modifier. This is supposed to be used as a debuff for enemies to reduce their critical star drop rates. But since they don't actually generate or use critical stars, this variable is not actually being used in the game right now, so we can ignore it. Critical modifier is 20% for critical hits and 0% otherwise. This actually feels a little low to me, since critical hits double the damage and double NP generation, you'd think they would double critical star generation also. Unfortunately, it's only a 20% bonus. Overkill modifier is a weird mechanic that actually ends up being set at 100% no matter what. That's 100% if you are not overkilling, and 100% even if you are. In essence, this does nothing, so we'll just toss it out. Overkill add is not so useless. On normal hits, it stays at 0%, but for overkill hits, this is set to 30%, which means an extra 30% added to everything at the end. Knowing all of that, let's simplify this to something I think is a little easier to look at. So, what does all this tell us? Well, a couple of things that will help when it comes time to build your team compositions. The first thing worth noticing is that critical star generation rate is flat out added to the overall value. A 50% critical star generation rate will add 50% to the overall drop chance. A 100 buff will add 100% to the overall drop chance. This is not the same as doubling the number of critical stars, by the way. If you were only at 50% to start and you add 100%, that means an average of triple the number of stars. But if you're already at 200% and you add 100%, that means only 50% more stars. The second thing worth pointing out is how card effectiveness buffs work. They aren't added straight like critical star generation rate buffs. They are actually multiplied by the card's star value. For quick cards, this means 80%, 130%, or 180%. In 2 out of 3 cases, this is an improvement. A 50% star generation buff will add 50% to the drop rate for any card, but a 50% quick card effectiveness buff will actually add 40%, 65%, or 90% to the drop chance per hit. It's also worth pointing out that a 50% Buster card effectiveness buff is only going to add 5%, 7.5%, or 10% to the drop chance. And a 50% Arts card effectiveness buff is not going to add anything at all to the drop chance. This means that quick card effectiveness is generally better than critical generation rate buffs. But critical star generation rate buffs are better when you're hitting with Buster cards or Arts cards. This is why you'll sometimes see servants with critical star generation rate command codes on their Buster cards instead of their quick cards. Say, for example, that we only have one Crest of Humanity command code, which will boost the star generation rate of the engraved card by 30%. If Jack has a star generation rate of 25.5%, she starts the chain with a quick card, and her third card is a quick card, then that last card will have a star drop chance of 225% without any command code on it. Engraving it with the Crest of Humanity will bring it up to 255%, which means an average of 13% more stars. If that last card was a Buster card instead, her drop rate falls to 65% without the command code, and 95% with it, for an average of 46% more stars. So you can see how that's potentially a bigger impact. It's also important to remember that you cannot generate more than 3 stars per hit, no matter how high your drop chance per hit gets. I covered this in the Beginner's Guide to Quick Teams, but let's do it again really quick. An 80% rate means 80% of hits will generate a single star. A 180% rate means that 80% of hits will generate 2 stars, and the remaining 20% of hits will only generate 1 star. A 300% rate will generate 3 stars on every single hit, and anything above 300% will do exactly the same. If we take the same scenario with Jack, but we let her use her own quick buff on herself, and we attack riders, all of a sudden her drop rate for that third card is already at 325% without any command codes. This isn't even factoring in any other buffs, craft essences, or mystic code abilities you might have at your disposal. Try to keep this in mind not only when you're choosing your command codes, but inside the match as well. Sometimes, it's better to space out your quick buffs if you need to, rather than stacking them all on at the same time and going way over 300%. Now that we know how to generate critical stars, the next obvious step is understanding how to gather critical stars on the cards you care about most. The formula is a lot easier to understand this time around, but we still need to talk about each part. Just like star generation rate, the base star gather rate is based off of your servant's class. This time around, it's the riders that shine the most, with a base rate of 200, then archers, who come in second with 150%. There are a lot of classes right around 100, and sitting firmly in last place again is the Berserker class with a rate of only 10%. Random factor is how the game keeps those stars from being too predictable, and one of the things that makes quick teams the hardest to use reliably. The way it works is this. The game will assign a random bonus to each of the five available command cards and add that to the base star gather rate. Two of the cards will get a bonus of 0, two of the cards will get a bonus of 20, and one of the cards will get a bonus of 50. This can be pretty frustrating if you're trying to get critical stars onto a card and it ends up with a bonus of 0, and all the stars get pulled to a different card which had a bonus of 50 instead. That's why picking the right classes can make a big difference. In a party with, say, two Berserkers and one Rider, the Rider is going to be able to grab almost all of the critical stars, even if they get the low random bonuses and the Berserkers get the higher random bonuses. That's why Riders and Archers are common choices for damage dealers in a quick-based team. The real problem comes when you're using an Assassin to generate your critical stars, but you want a Berserker to collect all of the stars and do the damage. Even if you're extremely lucky with a random bonus, your Assassin is going to steal most of the stars away. That's where the final part of the formula comes in. Buffs that increase your critical star gather rate will be multiplied by the sum of the base gather rate and the random factor. This means the better the base generation rate and the random bonus, the more impact your buff will have. After the rates are generated for all five cards, then the critical stars are distributed randomly. It's important to notice that a 100% gather rate doesn't actually mean a single card will get 100% of the stars. The rates of all the other cards will always factor in. So if all five cards have the same gather rate, then the stars will end up approximately evenly distributed. But if one of the cards has twice the rate, it will end up with approximately twice as many stars as the other cards will. Let's look at a specific example. Maeve, a Rider with EX luck, has a base gather rate of 208. If she gets lucky and rolls the 50% random bonus on her card, then that card will have a 258% gather rate. If we add a Be Elegant Craft Essence to Maeve, the rate for that card will jump by 25%, for a new total of 322.5%. Now let's look at a Berserker like Lancelot instead. With his B rank luck, he has a base gather rate of 10. If he gets lucky and rolls the 50% random bonus, his card will have a gather rate of 60% normally, or 75% with the Be Elegant Craft Essence. But wait a second, isn't Lancelot supposed to be famously good at getting critical hits? Even if we give him this great Craft Essence and add command codes like Focus, he still isn't going to be able to steal very many critical stars away from an Assassin generating stars, let alone another Rider in the party. So how does this work? Well, you can try your very best to stack CEs, command codes, and master skills like Iron Devotion together. Or look no further than Lancelot himself. His Eternal Arms Mastery skill boosts his own critical star gather rate by up to 6,000%. You'll see similar numbers for other Berserkers also, like Raiko, who has her own 6,000% gather rate buff. Now compare that to servants like Neza, whose buff increases her gather rate by 500% instead. This is how the game compensates for the fact that Berserkers need a much higher buff to overcome their low initial gather rates. So why is this important? It's good to know that classes with low gather rates like Berserkers and Avengers mostly rely on skills like this to collect critical stars. When you're building teams with them, you can sometimes skip CEs like Be Elegant and focus on CEs like Gem Magecraft to boost your critical attack damage instead. Sometimes, despite your best efforts though, the luck of the draw is still against you and the stars end up on the wrong card anyway. Don't give up hope because there are still a couple of small tricks you might be able to try. Using any kind of ability that increases anyone's critical star gather rate will cause the stars to be reassigned accordingly. That means that after using skills like Lancelot's Eternal Arms Mastery, all of the stars will be redistributed, giving you another chance for them to possibly land more favorably. The same goes for skills that reduce someone's critical star gather rate, such as Cha-Cha's version of Innocent Monster. You can also try skills that add critical stars, such as Kojiro's Vitrify or Bart's Swift Pillager. You can also take advantage of other skills that reduce the total number of critical stars to do the same thing, but this is generally less useful because, well, you're reducing the number of stars, which is obviously not ideal. Still, skills like Asteria's Star Judgment can make for an interesting strategy when used at the right time. Alternatively, you can also try anything that changes the command cards that are out, such as Ruler Altria's Royal Card skill, the Mages Association Uniform's Command Shuffle, or the Combat Uniform's Order Change. Redealing the cards will cause the stars to be assigned randomly again. I know that none of these tricks are really viable in the long term because you can't keep repeating them every turn, so it's best not to build a team around them entirely. Still though, it's good to know and can sometimes save you during a really crucial round in the fight. Finally, let's talk about using the critical stars on your cards. You have probably heard that critical hits will double the damage for each attack, and that's mostly true. I could show you the formula for calculating damage, but honestly, it would take even longer to explain than critical stars, so let me just point out three of the most common exceptions. Straight additions to damage, such as Core of the Goddess passive skills or the Volumen Hydrogyrum CE are not doubled. Buster Chains add 20% of a servant's attack to the overall damage, and this is not doubled either. And damage cuts, such as Mashu's Honorable Wall of Snowflakes, are taken out of the doubled damage. This sometimes causes a critical hit to do a lot more than double the damage would have if it was not a critical hit. If you use buffs to increase critical attack damage, such as Scotty's Primordial Ruin or the Gem Magecraft CE, you are adding to the normal 100% bonus damage. This means the extra 100% critical strength from Scotty's buff will result in a total of a 200% bonus, which in turn means 3 times the normal damage. If you use Merlin's Hero Creation skill to add another 100%, you end up with a total bonus of 300%, which means 4 times the normal damage. On top of this bonus damage, you may have heard that critical hits also double the effects of whatever card you attacked with. Unfortunately, this is only half true. NP generation is doubled, that part is true, but as we mentioned earlier, the critical star generation is only increased by 20%. Again, that feels weak to me in comparison, but it's better than nothing, I guess. I don't know, let me know what you think in the comments down below. And while you're there, let me know if I missed anything, or if you have any questions about critical stars in general. I know this is what makes quick-based teams a lot more complicated than Arts or Buster, but I think it's a pretty cool system that gives FGO a bit more depth. Quick teams do have a higher element of randomness than other teams, but trying to tweak every variable you can to stack that randomness in your favor is something that's always been pretty fun for me. Anyway, this concludes everything you ever wanted to know about critical stars and probably more, so all that's left to say is thank you for watching, and I'll catch you next time.